So it looks like we have everything ready before we blast off into space. We're just missing one final step.
What's the final step? Is it for you to buy your favorite sister some new shoes so she can blast into space in style?
No, but we can make a deal. If you can help me figure this last thing out, I will buy you a new pair of socks.
What am I going to do with a new pair of socks? Why would I even need a new pair of socks?
Well, for one, let's just say yesterday when you took off your shoes, even our poor dog Spike couldn't eat his food.
Whatever. I think he was afraid to eat his food because you were singing so loud it probably gave him permanent ear damage.
Okay, point taken. Let's just stop arguing because we have to figure this out, and I'm gonna need your help. We need to find the best place where we should blast off from.
How about I put you on a spaceship and I blast you off into another planet so that Bob the Blob can eat you?
What blob, and who is Bob?
I don't know. It's just a name I made up for that weird thing that attacked our space station. Okay, I'll stop. Seriously though, got to catch a name.
I can't with you. Anyways, so after doing some research and reviewing your research, there are multiple places where we can take off from. For example, we can blast off from one of the highest mountains, or a hill, or a valley, at sea level, or even from under the ocean.
Hey, I thought we already found the right elevation. Would our spaceship even take off from under the ocean?
Well, that was a joke, but I am glad at least I got you thinking. There are a couple of things we need to take into consideration, and it's not only the height of where we will be launching from, but we also have to think about the location and surroundings.
What do you mean?
We have to think about how dense the air is from where we will be launching from, whether there is a large open area, and if there are plants and animals close by that we can affect. But for now, let's just look at the height. We can go over how to order a set of numbers from least to greatest, or from greatest to least.
Well, that sounds interesting.
Ordering numbers from least to greatest, or greatest to least, is very similar to comparing numbers. You have to understand the values of each digit within a set of numbers to be able to put them in order.
Can you give me an example?
Yes, of course. Let's start with the highest points. So let's say you were asked to order from least to greatest the heights of three different mountains. We can call these mountains Mountain A, Mountain B, and Mountain C. Mountain A has a height of 23,525 feet, Mountain B has a height of 23,468 feet, and Mountain C has a height of 25,487 feet. Do you remember what we learned that helped us be able to compare numbers the last time?
Yes, of course. We used a place value chart.
Awesome! We can also use a place value chart to help us put these three numbers in order. Step 1 would be align all the numbers by place value. Step 2 would be compare all digits in each place value starting at the greatest place value. If we look at these three numbers, we can see that the greatest place value is in the 10,000s. We have the digit 2 in Mountain A, we also have another digit 2 in Mountain B, and we have another digit 2 in Mountain C.
So since they're all the same, what do we do next?
We move on to the next place value, which is in the thousands. In the thousands place, we have in Mountain A digit of 3, we have in Mountain B a digit of 3, and Mountain C we have a digit of 5.
Does this mean that the digit 5 has a value of 5,000?
Yes, and since 5,000 is greater than 3,000, this makes Mountain C our greatest height.
How about Mountain A and Mountain B?
Well, we can continue comparing the digits within these two numbers to identify the next largest number. We already saw that Mountain A and Mountain B have a digit of 2 in the 10,000s and a digit of 3 in the 1,000s place. Let's move on to the hundreds. If we were to look at the hundreds place, Mountain A has a digit of 5 and Mountain B has a digit of 4. Since 5 is greater than 4, or if we are talking about the value of the digits, 500 is greater than 400, we now know that Mountain A is greater than Mountain B. So if we were to pull all three mountains in order, Mountain C has the greatest height. Then it would be Mountain A, and at last, Mountain B. Does this make sense?
Yes, it does.
Well then, let's get to work and figure out what would be the best launching place with everything else considered.
Sounds good to me. Let's go.